had one great desire. And there in the book of Luke, chapter 22, and verses 15 and 16, we read, "And he said unto them, With desire I have desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I say unto you, I will not any more eat thereof until it be fulfilled in the kingdom of God." When Jesus spoke these words, he was thinking about his death. He was about to die. He was about to go to the cross. And what meant more to him as he faced crucifixion was intimate communion with his disciples. He wanted that. He wanted a close and intimate communion with his disciples. And therefore, he said, "With desire, I have desired to eat this Passover before I suffer." The word desire there in the Greek is the word epithumia, which is a great longing. It is having the emotions directed towards something. And that something that Jesus had in mind was intimate communion with his disciples. He wanted that, but the disciples delayed the process. They delayed the process because in their minds they were not very near to him. Yes, they were near to him in body, but not in mind. Not in mind, because in their mind they harbored jealousy. They harbored in their mind a maneuvering for power and position. They harbored in their minds selfishness and resentfulness. They harbored in their minds bad feeling towards one another. And so when Jesus yearned for coming together, when he yearned for communion, the condition of the disciples were divisive. This is a picture of a church. It is a picture of a church that Jesus longs to enjoy intimate communion with. And yet still everyone seemed to be obsessed with his own selfish ways. Everyone seemed to be obsessed with jealousy, with bitterness and resentment. Listen up, I'm going to say this to you first of all. Let me say this, because this is the ministry of humility. It's a time of confession. It's a time of reconciliation. I'm going to say this to you about you will never see me smile to you and have you in my heart. If I have something that I think I'm uneasy with you, you bet your life I'll tell you. So I'm not going to walk around and say this to this member about you. You will hear it from me. Am I speaking to real disciples in this place?
Speak. It's got to come forth.
What time? Jesus wanted intimate communion. But it was delayed by the disciples. It was delayed. Because they weren't in a condition for intimate communion. They weren't in a condition. I mean, they were around him physically, but mentally they were not there. Oh, it happens to us all the time in church. We can come together, dress up in our three-piece suit, sit beside one another, and we can pray and we can sing, but deep down in the recesses of our hearts, we hold grudges, we hold bitterness, we hold jealousy, we hold envy. I ask you today to be washed in the blood of the Lamb. washing service. It is not a time for chattering and talking at the foot washing service. It is not a time for us to be focusing on our own ideas and our own feelings. Jesus wants intimate communion with us.
The other.
be the greatest. There was a strife among them. Who should be the greatest? There was jealousy and resentment and feelings of bitterness there among those disciples. So they could not wash the others' feet. As a matter of fact, there in the Middle East, they couldn't do it because they had the idea that only a slave would do something like that. You know, when you went into the home of a person in the Middle East, at that time, there was this basin of water because, you know, they wore sandals. And so their feet got dirty. Yes, their feet got dirty. And so those who were rich had a slave at the door to make sure that the guest's feet was washed. Well, Jesus, as the place was set up, had no slave in there. Had nobody there to wash anybody's feet. And so everybody looking around, looking for somebody else to get up and do it. Nobody would get up and do it. And then all of a sudden, the Savior of the world got up. And he took the towel, had the basin of water, and he began to wash the disciples' feet. He washed their feet. Listen, I want you to see the imagery. It is the creator of the world. It is the God of the universe. It is the exalted one who stepped down, knelt before a sinner, and washed his feet. Jesus was done. He instituted the Lord's Supper. Broke bread with them. So the communion service is comprised of the Lord's Supper and the foot washing service. That's the communion service. The Lord's Supper and the foot washing service. Both comprise the communion service. You know, it should be easier now to wash feet because some folk, knowing it's communion, make sure that they wash their feet well and come to church. It should be easier. Those folk, their feet were messed up, dirty and filthy. It was an act of humility to get down and wash their feet. Humility, do we still have that today? Humility, lots of marriages are falling apart because nobody wants to be humble. Nobody wants to say, I am sorry. Nobody wants to say, I am wrong. Nobody wants to confess. Talk to young people now. Young people, this service, the ministry of humility, is for you. You live in an age where youthful sins are becoming expansive and explosive. Youthful sins! Right in the church, the research is clear that the same amount of fornication out there is in the church. The research is clear that the same amount of smoking dope outside can be found in the church. Yes. Not because you see folk all dressed up and look as though everything is okay. Mm-hmm. This is why we need the communion service. Yes. You don't have to go and get rebaptized. Go to the foot washing service. Yes. Get cleansed. Yes.
Amen.
And then come to the Lord's Supper. Young people, I want to talk to you because I noticed something here at Grandstaff. During Sabbath school, I see a whole lot of young people. So I want to make sure that when we gather together for the worship service, that all of our young people are in here. Because God has a word for young people. Now I'm going to say this to you, young people. Never yield to the temptation. constantly saying that church is boring, worship is boring, this is boring, that is boring. Check what kind of life they're living. I'm telling you from my experience. Go check it. Go look at it. Some of them are in fornication. Some of them are smoking dope. Some of them are drinking alcohol. I was telling one of my sons just this week, don't even think that I moved from 5 straight up to where I am. Don't even think about it. I'm traveling. I know. And I know when young people start talking about this boring and that boring. I know exactly what's up. Today, you've been baptized, but you've yielded to temptation. So you need to wash your feet. It's a symbol that the blood of Jesus Christ cleanses us from all sin. It's a fountain filled with blood. And then we're going to separate for the foot washing service. That's what we're going to do right now. We're going to separate for the foot washing service. I'm going to say this to you in the foot washing service. If you think somebody doesn't like you, go and wash the person's feet.
Amen. 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 Amen.
It's foot washing. It's the ministry of humility. You know what God can do with Grandstaff if we would forget about the bickering? If we would ask God to cleanse us, wash us, and be open to the move of His Spirit? Today! Wash feet! Because all of us here from the pulpit to the pew, our feet have gotten sing that song and then separate and be back for the Lord's Supper.